Hello Africa, my name is Lawrence Siamatyaba from Zambia. I'd like to share my personal story entitled "The God is the God in Me." When I finished high school, I was so blessed with an opportunity that I got married, had a son, and a good job. In spite of God blessing me in all these spheres, my behavior was very bad, as I used to abuse alcohol and patronize bars. God blessed me with a son, with this woman that I got married to. Because of my behavior, one day when she discovered that I had an affair with this woman, she was so disappointed. So as I went for work one day, I just received a text on my phone to say, "Your wife has committed suicide." When I ran home, I entered the bedroom and I found a note on the bed written to say, "I've never loved a man like you in my life. Take care of my son." And that's how I lost my wife. After burial, I continued an affair with this same woman that made my wife to commit suicide. One day we decided to book a lodge. When we entered the lodge, because I never knew that this woman was married, then two men entered the room. Deep down my prayer in my heart, I just said a prayer to say, "Lord, please save me. I've got a little boy to look after." So all these men did was, one of them picked a phone and captured my face and said, "Cheers, Mr. Lawrence," and that's how they walked out of the room. The following day when I went for work, I found a dismissal letter from my employers, and that's how I lost my job. Since then, my life has been very tough, looking for a job everywhere, nothing to find. All the properties that I had were gone. And up to now, I'm still struggling, until I was advised to seek professional counseling so that I can change my behavior. I use my story to share with the young people so that the opportunities that we have in life, we need to guard them jealously, because we never know how we can lose them out there with our careless behavior. So from my story, you can learn that because of my recklessness, I'm living a miserable life. So please, anyone listening to my story, take the opportunities that God has given you so seriously. Right now, I'm just helping out, but no one is able to help me. I train women on how to do farming and things like that, but nothing is coming forward. I've tried to apply for jobs 1,000 times. Nothing is coming out there. So I'm appealing to anyone who can help me with a job or anything so that I can have my life back. This is the end of my story. God bless you.